Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Neha and today we are going to practice how to do Chaturanga Dandasana. So before that, I want you to subscribe my channel and click a bell icon next to it so that any new video of mine will reach you directly. And also if you want to follow us or if you want to reach us through message or something, you can follow us on Instagram with the name Yoga for Cure. Getting back to the topic. So today we are going to practice Chaturanga Dandasana, which will be slightly difficult for a lot of people because it completely depends on your arm strength. As you see in the posture, you are holding your entire body weight on your shoulder, basically on your arms as well as on your toes. So more than toes, you are engaging yourself on your arms. When you go down closer to the floor, you are not dropping yourself on the floor, you are holding yourself up on your palm. So to start with, you need to make sure that you do enough warm up for your wrist as well as on your ankle. So ankle is pretty simple, just a few ankle rotation. And when it comes to the wrist, do some wrist rotations like in any of the directions, up and down, in and out. And in the end, just like try to hold your wrist, this is important, not like very tight, gently just give a massage kind of a thing to retain the energy. Do the same thing on the other side. So I'll not be explaining a lot about the wrist rotation right now, because if you want to have a good warm up, we already have a video on the wrist strengthening. You can see the link on the display right now. You can click here and you can practice, strengthen your wrist before you start the practice. So the background of this asana would be, if you know very well how to practice Ashtanga Namaskara, this is one of the steps in Surya Namaskara where you go on your arms to the floor using your shoulder strength. Similarly, it comes here. So if you are very good at Ashtanga Namaskara, then this posture will become very easy. Again, on Ashtanga Namaskara, I have made a video. You can see the link again. Alright, so let us start with it. As I've told you, make sure that you do enough wrist rotation and wrist warm up. Second thing is, when you are in the posture, there are few techniques through which I could gain good shoulder strength, because of which I am able to do it. I am going to share the same with you. If you practice, I am sure it will be helpful for you as well. So to first one, there is a measurement. If you take this measurement, it will be easy for you to have a proper alignment. So be in Vajrasana. From here, you take one arm distance. Plus, you have to add two palm, 1 plus 2, okay? So here what you have to remember, always in a practice, wrist and your shoulder, this should be in a straight line. For example, if you are here, your chest should be in center. Now you can observe my spine, it is not going inside or not going up. It's going to be stable. Chest is in the front, okay? So don't take your hip back. You see, the wrist is not in a straight line. Don't make it forward. Again, your wrist is not in a straight line. So come to a simple posture with the alignment. Your wrist and your shoulder should be in a straight line. Here, as I was mentioning to you how to practice Chaturanga to make your shoulders strong, before that, Ashtanga Namaskara, you have to just like drop your knee down, take your elbows inside, drop your chest down, and from here, see that if you push your floor, push the floor away from you and come up. It might be slightly difficult to start with, but then you have to do it how much of your body allows. Go down slowly with exhalation, push the floor away with the inhalation. Exhale down and inhale up. So slowly as you continue, you can lift your knee up, drop your knee down. Exhale down, inhale up and knee up. Continue this for like about 4 to 5 times more. As I've told you, start with your body capacity. If you think like your hands are not going down, practice this thing first. You have to get it right to increase the shoulder strength to do Chaturanga Dandasana. So once you are good at this posture, or at least you try to do this, moving on to another one, which is like pretty simple, but then like it's absolutely on your capacity. Full plank. From full plank, your wrist and shoulder are in a straight line. Here you're going to drop your elbows one by one. One. From here again, come back to full plank. palm down, push the floor and come up. Same thing, we're going to continue. Inhale, come up. This requires a lot of strengthening. Stomach slightly engaged. Last one, exhale down. Inhale, come up. You can already feel by this time that your shoulders are like, you know, it's slightly paining. You can feel the work which is done on your shoulders. So practicing this every day will increase a lot of strength in your arms as well as on your shoulders. So now once you get this, let's move into a proper posture, a technique how you can retain the posture. So if you can't get into Chaturanga directly, that's absolutely fine. Initially when I used to struggle with that, I'm sure a lot of people have struggled, but then you have to go through this experience. Now you can see like your wrist and your shoulders in a straight line, and your knee and your knees like not on the floor, and you are on your toe, right? From here, focus on dropping your body to the floor directly but keeping your elbows bent. Like take your elbows inside, starting if you can't hold, drop it down, okay? But make sure that elbows doesn't go out, it stays inside. Come up, inhale, exhale. From here, if you can't hold, drop it down. Let me try practicing like a beginner. You can see, if you can't hold, you drop it down. Absolutely fine. Because I want your arms to experience how does it feel to go down. So if you keep continuing for like 4 to 5 days, maybe you'll be able to like struggle, stay here, 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 and then here. One more time. From here, go down. Control, drop it down. So this is the technique for you to give an experience for your arms that how would you feel. So now I tell you what are the things that you should remember when you practice this. One is your spine. As I've told you, don't drop your spine this. So if you drop your spine down, you can't go down on your elbow. It will be a lot on your hands to take it. At the same time, don't push your hip up. It will become a mountain posture. Okay, so stay like in a straight line. Don't drop your neck down. See, you have to keep your shoulder blades in a straight line. So the moment you take your spine out, I mean your shoulder blades out, you feel like a lot of, you know, tightness in the back. It won't give a right posture. So try to open up your chest, keep a straight line and try to go with all the awareness. Last one. Here, on your toe, spine in a straight line, shoulders open up, keep looking forward. Inhale, exhale down. Elbow should not go outside, and then come to Bhujangasana. We'll give a bit of stretch in the spine, and then you can relax in a child posture. All right, so we have seen Chaturanga Dandasana, how to start with warm up technique. So you might not get it in one day, of course it's a very practical thing, but I'm sure if you keep practicing it for a week or 15, you should be able to do it very easily, because your body adopts the changes like very fast. So just like do a lot of warm up, I would say do a lot of Surya Namaskara, and then you try practicing these techniques, and this is very helpful for you to build the arm strength, spine strength as well as your thighs. So what will happen where you're holding yourself in a whole line in a straight line, you know, these postures are like very effective. The major benefits of this posture would be it will make your shoulders and your arms and your wrist very very strong. As you've seen that you're working a lot on your upper body, it will make it very strong. It will help you to tone up your body as well, because this is almost like a push-up where you're holding yourself. It is not going to be very easy. It comes in like slightly more than the beginner level, all right? And third thing, that it will help you for weight loss also. Like if you're doing a lot of other workouts, anything else, like, you know, like any workout or yoga, if you want to tone yourself for weight loss, you can add this posture and try to stay there as much as possible. And who cannot practice this? If you have gone through any major injuries in your shoulders, and then probably you'll have to, you know, avoid it. And if you have anything, any major injuries in your spine or something, maybe you can check with your doctor before practicing this. And one of the best thing about this posture for the girls, usually girls will struggle with the shoulder strength, you know, so they can't do much of those push-ups initially unless and until they really put lot of effort. So if you want to do push-ups completely, this posture is very, very helpful because it's gonna add a lot of strength to the shoulders as well as to the arms. Altogether, it's gonna be amazing posture for the upper body. Keep practicing and you can write your comments in a comment section. We'll definitely look into it and answer all your doubts. Thank you so much.